Okay, so this is our last question. This is question number three, which is corporation tax. And you are provided with accounting PNL, accounting PNL, accounting PNL. See, they give you accounting PNL and then you work according to tax, right? So you have gross profit. And then this is, see, this is depreciation and amortization. These all are accounting. These all are accounting, accounting depreciation and accounting amortization. You all remember accounting depreciation and accounting amortization are not allowed, not allowed, not allowed. So we need to add back. But yes, instead of this accounting depreciation, you will get capital allowance. Instead of this accounting depreciation, you will get a gift. You will get a gift, which is called capital allowances, capital allowances. Yes, we'll calculate. Don't worry. One more capital allowance, you'll see. And instead of this amortization of leasehold, yes, you will get amortization of leasehold property. Remember the property income area, property income and trading income area, amortization of leasehold property, amortization of leasehold property. There is some amortization given by tax department, which is separate. So both of these accounting depreciation and accounting amortization will be added back. Both of these. Both of these accounting depreciation and accounting amortization will be added back, will be added back. Okay. And instead of these two, you will get a ready-made tax things, tax depreciation, which is capital allowances, and tax amortization. Okay. Now, finally, they are asking for other expenses. Wait, these are the other expenses. But before we move on to other expenses, first, let's first read the requirement. Let's first read the requirement. This is the requirement. See, calculate the Venus Limited corporation tax liability for the year ended. Don't forget, this is your accounting period. This is your accounting period, 31st March 2023. This is your accounting period, 31st of March 2023. This is your accounting period, 31st of March 2023. Right? Okay. Your computation, see, they are guiding you. Please read the requirement carefully. I always say in my classes that I beg students to read the requirement. Invest your time on requirement. Your computation should commence from operating profit figure of 200692. See, this is easy thing. Examiner is asking you to start from operating profit by indicating using zero at any item which do not require adjustment. Okay. You should assume that the full annual investment allowance is available to Venus Limited. Okay, AIA. So now what you will do? Now what you guys will do? You have to start from... See, this is... Let me break the question. This is the first breaker. You have to start from operating profit numbers. So these adjustments are the your first adjustment. These top adjustments are top first adjustment. And these all are other incomes. These all are other income. They are not trading income. So first of all, this area is trading income. This area is trading income. And the lower side, these are other incomes. Obviously, obviously, if you need to calculate complete final corporation tax, so we have to work out on all other incomes. But the first target is this. First target is this. And let me give you a highlight. Let me give you... You know, I say this in Ishara. Let me give you a pointer that you remember a journey from accounting profit to tax adjusted trading profit. You remember a journey from accounting net profit to tax adjusted trading profit. Accounting net profit to tax adjusted trading profit. This is the journey. This is the journey. Okay. So for this journey, first of all, we need to add back all not allowed expenses. So this accounting depreciation is not allowed and accounting amortization is also not allowed. Okay. Instead of, wait, and what about the other expenses? For other expenses, read, these are entertaining UK customers not allowed. Entertaining UK customers never allowed, never allowed for trading income. Entertaining customers is straight away not allowed. So it will be added back. Gifts to customers, food, not allowed. If you are giving a, you remember the rules, it should be less than 50 pounds. It should not be food, anything to eat. and they contain the company name. If these three conditions are met together, then it is allowed. But here it is clearly written it's food. So if you're giving food to your customers, it's not allowed at all. Now, qualifying checks, QCD, it's also not allowed. QCD is not allowed from trading income. From trading income, QCD is not allowed. Yes, it is allowed from total profits. QCD, qualifying charitable donations, are not allowed from trading income. Yes, it is. It is allowed from total profits. So these three are not allowed. So we'll add back. Don't forget this. Okay. Now let's fix the two depreciation. It is written amortization of leasehold property 4,000. Now read this leasehold property line. Hope you remember. On 1st October 2022, wait, your accounting period is this. Your accounting period in this question is 1st April 22 to 31st March 23. You can open your eyes and see the accounting period. Or I would say whenever a question starts, first of all, always see the accounting period. First of all, always see the accounting period. So your accounting period is 1st April 22 to 31st of March 23. 1st April 22 to 31st of March 2023. 1st April 22 to 31st March 2023, right? And you have taken the property on lease on mid of the year. See, 1st October 22 is mid of the year. So only 6 months amortization will be available. Only 6 months amortization will be available. Venus Limited acquired a leasehold office building by use for the business. See, we are using this property for business. That's why the amortization of lease premium will be allowed from business income, right? Paying a premium of 96,000 for a 12-year lease. Wait, let me teach you in the same way I taught you guys in the class. See, we are Venus. The other guy is A. So the other, we gave them 96,000. So the other guy received the premium. We'll write premium received, which is 96,000. Now, hope you remember the relief. Less 2% into N is 12. 12 minus 1. 2% into 12 minus 1. So 11 multiplied by 2 is 22% of 96,000. Yes, this is taxable premium. This is taxable premium for A. And now listen, whatever amount is taxable premium for A, this amount will be allowed for V. So how to calculate amortization? We'll write 74880 divided by lease term is 12 years. Can anybody tell me divide by 12 is how much? It's 6240. But again, 6240 is per annum. 6240 is per annum. And we are only eligible for 6 months. We are only eligible for 6 months. It's 3120. So 3120 is allowed expense. 3120 is the tax allowable amortization. So accounting amortization is not allowed. This amortization is allowed. And my dear respected student, if you have solved the questions of KIT, these are normal questions. On average, in every other question of corporation tax, examiner gives this transaction. Okay, now let's move to the capital allowance section. let's move. This is the capital allowance section, but don't forget, this is companies. In companies capital allowances, there is one topic of super deduction. You know, there is a new topic of super deduction, 130%. 130% for main pool and 50% for a special rate pool. 130% of for main pool and 50% for a special rate pool. This is only for companies. This is only for companies. And this is a separate topic other than AIA. AIA is still there. AIA is still there. Remember? So I hope you remember. Now, on 1st April 2022, the tax written down value of plant and machinery. This is the main pool opening balance. Very good. And this is special rate pool. So nothing new. Nothing new. Just make two columns. MP, main pool and special rate pool. Write the opening balances. Now, you have bought this car, car 1. And the CO2 is 115. So it will go in SRP. The CO2 is 115. The CO2 is 115, which is greater than 50. So it will go in special rate pool. Simply special rate pool. It will go directly in a special rate pool. It will go directly in a special rate pool. Right? Then new delivery van is a main pool item, and for delivery van never see the CO2. This is a dodge. This is just a dodge. Never ever see CO2 for van. In past paper question previously they have given that this dodge. So this is dodge. So this is main pool item 16,000. Yes, as this is a main pool and this is a when examiner is saying new. It's a new van. So it will be eligible for 130% super deduction. It will be eligible for 130% super. It's not car. Yes, I can understand. No AIA on cars, no super deduction on cars. Cars, they never give. But this is van. There is a difference between van and car. Car is a luxurious thing. Van accommodates 10, 15 people at a time. So van is a good thing, right? So for van is eligible for AIA as well, but we won't claim AIA because 130% is better. AIA is just 100%. Super deduction is 130%. Let me call it, say this in Urdu. AIA mein sirf 100% milta hai na aapko. Aur super deduction mein 130% milta hai. So super deduction achha hai. Hamesha main pool mein aapne kara hai question, right? Next. Equipment we bought second hand equipment is a main pool item, but as it is a second hand, if you have read the law, I can show you the past, even in my class I have read the law, the article picture. As this is second hand, so it will not qualify for super deduction, but yes, it will qualify for AIA. It will not qualify for super deduction, but yes, for AIA you can. If you have bought any asset which is secondhand, it will qualify for AIA. It should not be car. No AIA on cars. So we'll apply AIA. This is the, my dear student, this is the law. If you remember the law, super deductions are only applied on new assets, not old secondhand assets. Okay. So now you don't have super deduction here. So the other way is AIA. Now car 2, you bought, the CO2 is 40. Yes, this is main pool car. This car will simply go in main pool without any AIA and super deduction. On cars, there is no AIA and there is no super deduction. On cars, there is no AIA and no super deduction. One very good thing last here. On 15th March 23, Venus Limited sold car 1. See, this is car 1. Car 1, same period you buy the car, same period you sold the car. In the same period, you just bought the car and in the same period, you are selling the car. But this is a pool car. So you have to add and subtract in the same period. You have to add and subtract in the same period. I'll show you. So you sold it for 16,750. Like, wait, let me explain you. This is special rate pool. What you will do? The opening balance of special rate pool in this question is 12,740. Look at the screen. Opening balance Edition car one. Edition car one. Car one you bought for 22930. And then in the disposal, you sold the car one. You sold the car one for this amount, 16750. So what will happen? What will happen? See, the difference of addition and subtraction will automatically be added in the pool. The difference of addition and subtraction will automatically be added in the pool. You can't get, you cannot get immediate balancing adjustment on pool items. This is pool items. So what is the final balance? The final balance will be 6% on it. Okay, on 6%. So whenever you buy any pool items, look at here. Whenever you buy any pool item in the same period and sold in the same period, still you have to add and subtract, and the difference will automatically be added in the balance. Okay, this is how you do it. Right? So take the picture of this area. I'm going to cover it in the Excel part. Take the picture of this part of the question. And you know, for super deduction, you must have taken my classes. I have covered this in my normal classes, super deduction. This message for all of you. You guys are not taking classes. Please, you have to take the class. The class is the primary document. So finally, through this working wheel, calculate capital allowance. I have already explained you. For new delivery van, yes, super deduction is available. But for this second-hand equipment, super deduction is not available. Super deduction is only allowed for new items. Okay. So here we'll calculate AIA. And yes, this is car two. Car two is a car. On cars, there is no AIA, no super deduction. So finally, let me go to this area. This is the trading income area. Students, see the screen. I have enlarged it. This is the trading income area. I have just explained you depreciation, amortization, accounting depreciation and amortization will be added. Instead of these two, you will get the tax allowable depreciation, which is called capital allowance, which I will calculate on Excel. And I have just explained you. And this, instead of this amortization, they will give you the tax allowable amortization, which I have already calculated. And yes, for the other expenses, I have already explained you that there were three expenses given in note number one. These all three of them are not allowed. All three of them are not allowed, so they will be added back. All three of them are not allowed, so they will be added back. Now, my respected student, till here we have done trading income. Now let's move to the other income. These are the other incomes. This is interest received. This is dividend received. And these are CGT. This is CGT. Dividend income is always exempt. For companies, dividend income is always exempt, no matter from where it is coming. For companies, dividend income is always exempt. Put this in your mind. So this dividend income line is irrelevant. You will write zero. For companies, dividend income is not taxable. Yes, interest received, interest income is taxable and on accrual basis. If you know accounting, on accrual basis, interest income is taxable and we call it loan relationship head. And this is CGT. So first I'll cover interest income on accrual basis as we are doing companies. So we have to do interest income. We need to do interest income on accrual basis. Okay. Now read this line. Note number three, and keep your accounting period in your head. Keep your accounting period in your head. Don't try to slip it. The bank interest received during the year ended 31st March 23 of 18050 relates to the deposits held for non-trading. Yes, non-trading. In addition, on 10th of April 2023, 350 of the non-trading loan interest was received. See, this 10th April 23 means after 10 days of the accounting period end. 10th April 23 means after 10 days of the period accounting period end. In relation to the year ended 31st March 23, that means this 350 was accrued at the year end. This 350 was accrued at the year end, accrued at year end. You can easily think. See, this 350 is received after the year end. This 350 is physically received after the year end, but this amount belonged to last year. Read this English line. Read this line. So this is the cash received. This is the cash received, and this is the closing accrual. This is the closing accrual. I hope you remember, those who have taken my classes, I used to make T account. I used to teach T account. See, this is interest receivable account. Here we write cash, actual cash interest, and this is closing accrual. This is closing accrual. So how much cash we have received? How much cash we have received? It's 18050. And how much is the closing accrual? This is 350. So automatically your P&L, your income according to accrual basis, your income according to accrual basis will be 18400. This is 18400 will go in your tax sheet. 18400 will go in the tax sheet if you are doing companies. But just think, for individuals, can anybody tell me, for individuals, interest income is taxed on cash basis? For individuals, interest income is taxed on cash basis. If this question belonged to individuals, then this will be your taxable amount. This will be your taxable amount. But right now you are doing companies, so this is your taxable amount. This. Keep this differences with you. For tax paper, memory is the most important tool. Yadash. So 18400 is the amount. Okay. Now, dividend received during the year 31st, Venus Limited, this is irrelevant. Yes, this 80% subsidiary, there is a topic of group of companies. It will apply 70. See, open my eye. My eyes are getting bigger after looking at this. 80% UK subsidiary means more than 75%. So there is a topic which is called group of companies will may be applied here. But these dividends are irrelevant. Whatever dividend you receive, no tax on dividends. Whatever dividend you receive, there is no tax on dividends. There is no tax on dividends. Okay. Finally, the last line of almost second last line of this question. Profit on disposal of shares. First, go to the question. See, they are telling you this thing. Profit on disposal of shares. Apparently, here it is 70,300. Apparently here it is 70,300, but let's see the adjustment. They are saying the profit on disposal of shares in respect of 2% shareholding that was sold on 18th. Yes, you sold in your own accounting period. You sold it in your own accounting period. Listen, the disposal resulted in a chargeable gain of 62880 after taking account of indexation allowance. Yes, this is relevant. This is relevant. So no matter in the accounting P&L, no matter the above P&L was accounting P&L, in the accounting P&L, the number was 70,300. In the accounting P&L, the number was 70,300, but this number is relevant, 62880, because they are saying this is after taking account of indexation allowance. And yes, indexation allowance is available. Indexation allowance is available if you have bought shares before December 2017. And this is possible. They are selling it here. They are selling right now. There is a possibility they bought it like 10 years back. So yes, they are in the question. They are saying this company is eligible for indexation allowance. This company is eligible for indexation allowance. So my dear student, we'll take this number. We'll take this 6288. This number is relevant. This number is relevant and it will come in a straight line. In single line, it's ready made. It's ready made number. And yes, for companies, indexation allowance is available. But for individuals, indexation allowance is not available. For companies, indexation allowance is available. For individuals, it's not available. For individuals, you remember there is one word, annual exemption, annual exemption, annual exemption. Okay, now the last line and then we'll shift to Excel. The last line is this, note number 7, group relief. Group relief is means 75% group, 75% group, okay? For the year ended 31st March 23, Mars Limited, the 80% UK subsidiary, made a trading loss of 7635. Venus Limited has made a group relief claim for the year in respect of this loss. Very easy. See, we are Venus and we have 80% holding in Mars. Okay. And both are UK based companies. So they have a trading loss. They have a trading loss. Now listen, of 7,000 something. So this, first of all, first question, is there any 75% group? Yes. Only direct holding, which is greater than 75. Venus Limited has direct holding, which is greater than 75. So yes, there is a 75% group between Venus and Mars. Now, 75% group is also called group relief group. These members can easily transfer their trading loss. The members of 75% group can easily transfer their trading loss to their members. And yes, when they will transfer, see, this is surrendering company and this is claimant. So claimant companies, TTP, we will cancel the TTP. This trading loss will cancel the TTP, total taxable profits of Venus Limited. Remember the 75% group. So if the 75% group is made, the trading loss can easily be transferred from surrendering company to claimant company. This will be the last step of my question when I'll be solving it. Okay. So now we are moving towards that Excel part, that spreadsheet part. But before I move on there, I would request you to take the picture of the question. Otherwise, you won't be able to see the question now. This is the second page. Wait. My dear student, only 15 minutes max are left now. Only 15 minutes investment is there. Just take the picture of this part. This is the second page of the question so that you have at least question with you. And this is the first page. This is the first page of the question. At least take the picture so that you can do it. Okay. Now, at least I have explained you the question. Don't treat me as a stranger. Don't treat this question as a stranger. We have discussed each and every part. So now I will simply type and I'll solve it. Okay. On my Excel sheet. Let's do it. Okay. So we have, this is our question. This is our question, but what we'll do, we need to solve the trading income. So in order to solve the trading income, first we'll be doing, wait, let me make it this one. First, we will be doing the capital allowance thing. First, the only technical area is capital allowance in this question. So let me go to the capital allowance area. Wait. Let me enlarge it. Okay. So what is the main pool opening balance? Wait, let me check. What is the main pool opening balance? It's going to be 8,400. Yes. You can see the question. It's 8,400. And then special rate pool opening balance is 12,740. Okay. Now, there was a car. Wait. There was a car. Car one is the car with CO2 of, I think, 110. With CO2 of, I think, 110 or 115. So car one will be added in main pool. Car one is 22,930. It will directly added in main pool. And you know this, that cars are never ever eligible for AIA. Okay. And in the same period you sold it. Okay. So, and you sold it for how much? 16750. You sold it for 16750. So I can do it like opening balance, add addition less disposal. So it's 18920. It's 18920, right? And how much is the percentage for special rate pool? It's 6%. So let's do it in one shot. This balance multiply by 0.06. See, this is the capital allowance, and no need to calculate the closing balance, no relevance. Just simply copy paste it. That's it. Okay. Simply copy paste it. So first thing you have calculated. Now, the other thing you bought is delivery van is not a car, and yes, it's new, as it is new and as it is a main pool item, so it will qualify for super deduction, which is 130%. So new delivery van is 16,000. And now apply a super deduction of how much? 130%. So it will be like this, multiply by 1.3. 130% is 1.3. So it's 20,800, and this will straight away go in allowance column. This 20,800 will straight away go in allowance column because this is a clear allowance on the spot. One more thing, you bought secondhand equipment for 52,112, but as this equipment is secondhand, so no more super deduction. But yes, as it is bought, so we can claim AIA, as it is not a car. So we can easily claim AIA, and AIA is 1 million. AIA is a very big amount. So we have a very big limit. So 52,000 is nothing. So we can easily claim complete AIA here. We can easily claim 52. How much is the AIA? Same amount, 100%, 52,112. Okay. So this will exactly copy paste, right? Okay, 52,212. Or you can write it like this in the brackets, wait. 52,112. Okay, 52,112. Now, Then you bought a car two. Then you bought a car two. Car two has a CO2 emission rate of 40. Car two has a CO2 emission rate of what? 40, less than 50. So it's a main pool car, and car always goes directly in the pool. If it is not a privately used car, and obviously in companies, there is no concept of privately used car by owner. So car two is 26470. 26470, okay? So almost everything is done. Now let's calculate the main pool. Main pool total is, the main pool total is opening balance is 8400 and 26470 will be added. Now the WDA rate is, the WDA rate is how much? It's like 18%, 0.18. 6277, 6277 will go here. So finally, you have calculated almost everything. Let me finally total it. 80324. You guys must not have any problem in this area. Capital allowances, we have done a lot of practice, but this is for companies. Companies' capital allowances is nowadays different. Companies' capital allowances is a little bit different because of the new area of super deduction. Because of the new area of super deduction. Okay. Did you understand this capital allowance? Can you write on the chat box, please? Did you understand the capital allowance thing? Okay, now keep this thing in mind that the cell number is H52. Now, one more thing I would like to work here, and this is the premium received, the leasehold thing. Premium received was 96,000. If I'm not wrong, premium received was 96,000. Unless this was, I think, bracket open. Sorry, 2%. 2% into N is 12 minus 1. Multiply by the premium received. Okay. Multiply by the 90%. So equal to minus 2% is 0.02, bracket open, 12 minus 1, bracket close, into 96,000. Oh, sorry, I forgot to write one sign. Okay, so this will be 21120. So this is your taxable premium for A. And now how much will be the deduction? You will write here this divided by 12. And you know, as we are allowed for amortization for 6 months, remember the 6 months. So you can do 0.5. 3120. Oh, wait. Equal this divided by 12 years into 0.5. Yes, it's 3120. So this is your amortization of lease premium, which we have already calculated. Okay. So now finally, we are ready for the main sheet. Let's do it. In the question, it was written, start with operating profit. What is the operating profit? 200692. Now, accounting depreciation and accounting amortization are not allowed. So you need to add back accounting depreciation, which is 32046, 32046. Then accounting amortization is, I think, 4,000. Okay. Then you have entertaining UK customers is not allowed, which is 3,600. Then you have food gift hampers not allowed, which is 2,730. Then you have qualifying charitable donations not allowed from trading income. Yes, they are allowed from total profit, but not allowed from trading income, which is 1,410. Then we have leasehold premium. Just we calculated 3,120. And then we have the capital allowances. We just calculated 80324. See, the leasehold premium and capital allowances are deducted. That's why they are in negative number. So finally, we have done the major part of this question. You got 161034 as your trading profit. 161034 as your trading profit. First income is done. Trading income is done. Now wait, remember when I teach in class, I teach corporation tax in this way. Whenever somebody asks you to calculate tax for individuals, three columns comes in your mind: non-saving, interest and dividend, non-saving, interest and dividend, non-saving, interest and dividend. But whenever I ask you to calculate corporation tax, what things comes in your mind? Things which comes in your mind is just single pro forma. And that is trading income, capital gains, property income, and interest income. Remember, so trading income is there. Trading income is perfect. Now the next is interest income. For interest income, remember I showed you the T account. I showed you the T account in my iPad working. So the closing accrual, see, this is the closing accrual of 350. And this is your cash received. So if you add these two, it will become 18400. You can also do a separate working for this. But it's a small working. And dividend income is irrelevant. You will write zero. Dividend income is exempt. And chargeable gain, we have to copy from the question 62880. Remember the adjustment 62880. They have given you chargeable gain after annual exemption. So let's calculate the total profits now. This is your total profit 242314. So if you deduct, QCD from total profit, you get the first TTP. So your QCD are one, qualifying charitable donations are 1410. Now, this is your initial TTP. Yes, this is your initial TTP. Okay. But my dear student, there is some group relief group. There is some group relief in this question. Remember the Mars Limited. We are Venus Limited and Mars Limited is our 80% subsidiary. So 80% is greater than 75%. And yes, whenever the percentage is greater than 75, you can take their trading losses if they are within UK companies. You can take their trading losses. So how much trading loss was coming? 7635. 7635 trading loss was coming. 7635. Okay. So finally, your taxable profits will be, your own taxable profits will be 233269. And what is the corporation tax rate? I assume you all know it's 19%. Corporation tax rate is 19%. So this is 44321. And that's the end of this question. Right? So finally, I would request you to be active with all the past papers. Keep revising things. Keep helping your friends, because you know, this is the paper of small things of memorization. So if you help somebody, your concepts will be refreshed. And just don't rely on oral things. Especially section C, you need to solve one. Your fingers must face the type typing round, okay? You have to solve questions practically on ACCA practice platform. Then only you will get it. Then only you will get something, right? Okay. So I hope you understood this concept. This was not difficult. If you have taken the classes, obviously the classes are important. The first thing is you have to take the normal class, normal lectures, and then you can easily do the past papers. Okay. So at least solve complete Kaplan kit. Complete Kaplan kit is mandatory for everybody. I always say this in my class. Complete Kaplan kit is mandatory for all the students, right? ACCA Study Hub is extra resources, but the first document which you must solve is your exam kit, Kaplan exam kit. Yes, I'll share. Okay. So it's time to say goodbye and take care and stay in touch on WhatsApp. Thank you.